It's been a really, really messed up week. 7 days of torture, 7 days of bitter, and my girlfriend went and cheated on me. She's a California dime, but it's time for me to quit her. La, 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 whatever. La, 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 it doesn't matter. La, 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 oh well. La, 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 we're going at it tonight. Tonight, there's a party on the rooftop, top of the world. Tonight, tonight, and we're dancing on the edge of the Hollywood sign. I don't know if I'll make it, but watch how good I'll fake it. It's alright, alright. I woke up with a strange tattoo. Not sure how I got it, not a dollar in my pocket, and it kinda looks just like you. Mixed with Zach Galifianakis. La la la, whatever. La la la, it doesn't matter. La la la, oh well. La la la, we're going at it tonight. Tonight, there's a party on the rooftop, top of the world. Tonight, tonight, and we're dancing on the edge of the Hollywood sign. I don't know if I'll make it.
When I left you, we were talking about finances. After adding up all the expenditures I had, I figured out that I spent $26,386,234.77. I wasn't done. I felt to start my adult life, I needed a fly ride.
The Aventador follows the Countach, Diablo, and Murcielago line of mid-engine Lamborghinis. On first glimpse, you might think the Aventador is a little different, but that would be a mistake. It's an all-new car that weighs 198 pounds less than the Murcielago and makes 30 more horsepower. The passenger cell is a complete carbon fiber monocoque, made at a newly constructed facility at Lamborghini's headquarters in Sant'Agata Bolognese. Bolted to the carbon passenger cell are front and rear aluminum frames that feature a new forged aluminum pushrod suspension design that carries the latest in carbon ceramic brakes, forged wheels, and Pirelli tires. Like its predecessor, the Aventador has a 60-degree V12 with 6.5 liters of displacement. And, like the earlier V12s, it will like to rev. The quad-cam V12 with variable valve timing and 4 valves per cylinder is capable of 700 horsepower and 509 pound-feet of torque, with fuel efficiency that's improved by a claimed 20%. That newfound power is passed to a new 7-speed independent shifting rod transmission. It's an automated manual, like the E-gear transmissions of the past, but with the ability to shift gears quicker thanks to gear selection being made by 2 shift forks rather than 1. It retains a single clutch, and thus saves weight and space over a dual-clutch design. Due to its design, the Aventador can't be a 3-pedal manual. But on the upside, the ISR shifts 40% quicker than the newest E-gear used in a Gallardo, and it has a 7th gear.
Okay, so what? Another $397,700. It's really not that much, right? Oh, well, and then there is the fact that I got the house furnished. That was only $856,007. Oh, God. This is a lot of money. After going through all my expenses, I realized we were going through some financial difficulties. I had to bring it to Megan's attention, which was something I didn't want to do. I told her, and much to my surprise, she was totally fine with it. In fact, she had a solution. She told me her net worth was $15 million, and her butt alone was insured for $75,000. She makes about $1.8 million per movie, and is currently working on the movie Wonder Woman for DC Comics. My so-called financial problems were solved instantaneously. I love you, Megan. Now, in every great relationship, there is a cook. But with both of our jobs being so demanding, we decided to interview for a chef to hire. I started interviews with a man named Louis, and he seemed great.
Les poissons, how I love les poissons! Love to chop and to serve little fish! First I cut off their heads, then I pull out their bones. Ah, mais oui, ça c'est toujours délish. Les poissons. With a cleaver, I hack them in two. I pull out what's inside and I serve it. God, I love little fishes, don't you? Here's something for tempting the palate. revered in the classic technique. First you pound the fish flat with a mallet, then you slash through the skin, give the belly a slice, then you rub some salt in, cause that makes it taste nice. Zut alors, I have missed one. Sacrebleu, what is this? How on earth could I miss such a sweet little succulent crab? Quel dommage, what a loss. Here we go, in the sauce. Now some flour, I think, just enough. Now I'll starve you with bread. It don't hurt, cause you're dead. And you're certainly lucky you are. Cause it's gonna be a hot in magic silver pot. Tout de l'eau, mon poisson, au revoir. What is this?
I think I'd better go see what Louis is up to.
Come out, you little pipsqueak, and fight like a man!
Louis! What are you doing?
No, I'm sorry, madame.
Maybe Louis was not the best fit here. We actually ended up hiring a new guy named Gaston, who came to us to figure out our menus for the week. Good morning, Gaston. I was wondering if you could inform us as to what the menu will look like this week.
Good day, my lord. Surely I will tell you everything you will be consuming in this week. Breakfast items for the week, my lord, include Wheaties, bagels with cream cheese, assorted fruits, waffles, bacon, omelets, Wawa sizzlies, Special K cereal, and Diet Coke. Lunch will consist of what I like to call a foot-long sub every day of the week, accompanied with a bag of chips and a large, immense supply of Coca-Cola Zero. Would your dinner choices are a varied assortment as follows. Fish, calamari, chicken parmesan, steak, spaghetti and meatballs, turkey, and to freshen your whistle, Coca-Cola Zero.
Why, thank you, Gaston. That's a terrific menu. I was just wondering, how much, approximately, will it be to keep up this menu for the next coming weeks?
My lord, the menu consists of $500 per week and must be kept up with.
Okay, thank you, Gaston, I appreciate it. It really is nice to realize that I can live my life with little financial hardship at all. With Megan and my combined incomes, life is and always will be easy. We've been married for 7 months now, and we just got great news. We found out Megan is pregnant. Perfect timing, she just finished shooting her motion picture Wonder Woman. I had to prepare for the baby. I found a baby gym for $27.57, a car seat, which is a necessity for any child, for $75.52, a stroller, which came with beach wheels, for only $100, and I found a crib for $202, but through this website, tinytykes.com, they offered not only the crib, but also a pillow, an extra bed rail, a mattress pad for the crib, 2 blankets, 2 sheets, and a toddler bed, also a bassinet. I couldn't pass that up. So I went with that for $450. When I add up all of these items, the total comes to $800, plus the $653.09 I spent on the previously listed stuff. That totals $1,453.09. That's the total it takes to get ready for a baby. Not to mention formula costs. A can of formula is about $13.99. You figure a newborn baby drinks about one can per week. Times that by 52 weeks and the total comes to $728 the first year alone. It's astronomical. On March 23rd, my son, Alfred Kevin McGurl, was born at 3:23 a.m.
Drive myself insane if those lips aren't speaking my name.